The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 8 through 14, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in September of 1966 in New York.
Raso ham apsu kauntya prabhasmi sasisurja pranava sarvideshu Sabda Khet Paura Sangha Nishu. Now Lord Krishna is describing how you become Krishna conscious fully in every step of your life. This verse we have been discussing last day. That Rasoham Apsu Kauntya. Now this glass of water, the taste, the juice of this water is Krishna. You cannot, when you are thirsty, this water given by God, there is no other replacement. If somebody offers me, instead of water you drink gold, no, this water is required. The taste of the water is so nice, that when I am thirsty, I require water. No manufacturer can create this taste of the water. Therefore, which is not possible to produce by any human being, that is God. So rasoham apsu kauntya. We can remember Krishna and God when we drink water. Because nobody can avoid drinking water. So, God consciousness is there. How can you forget? Rasoham apsu kauntya prabhasmi sasi surya. When there is some illumination, when there is some illumination, you want to come here? Yes, please. When there is some illumination, that illumination is also Krishna. The original effulgence is Brahma Jyoti, that is in the spiritual sky. This material sky is covered. Therefore, the nature of the material sky is darkness. Now at night, we are experiencing the real nature of this material world. It is darkness. Artificially, it is being illuminated by the sun, by the moon, by the electricity. Otherwise, it is darkness. So this illumination is God. We have to understand this illumination. Now, how this illumination is coming? Originally, in the spiritual sky, just like the sun has its shining force, which is called sunshine, similarly, from the kingdom of God, there is a shining which is called Brahma Jyoti. The Brahma Jyoti is reflected by the sun. The moon is reflected by the sun. Sun is reflection of Brahma Jyoti and moon is reflection of the sun. Everyone, you know, the stars, glittering stars, they are also reflection of the sun. Similarly, this electricity is also a reflection of sun. The diamond, the jewel, everything, that is reflection of sun. That's all right. So, Krishna said, prabhasmi sasi surjaya. Sasi means the moon, and surya means the sun. And in the spiritual world, there is no need of sun and moon. Natatra bhasayati surja natatanta napavata. In the spiritual world, there is no need of sun, there is no need of moon, there is no need of electricity. Because in the spiritual sky, everything is illuminated. So there is no need. So we can remember God or Krishna when you see some illuminating property. Pranama sarva-vedesu, when we chant Vedic mantra, Om Tadvisnam Paramam Padam Sadapashyanti Suraya, Om Bhudhuvasata Saridu Varannam Bhargur Devasa Dhimai. Now this Omkar, Om, that is the beginning. This Omkar is addressing, just like we are addressing Hare Krishna, this is also addressing. O Hara, O Krishna, this Omkar is also addressing. So this Omkar is Krishna, is God. Pranamas sarva-vedesu, sabda-khepa-urasana-nishu. And sabda means sound. Whenever you hear some sound, you should know this is vibration of the transcendental sound. The sound which we are vibrating, that is pure spiritual sound. But any sound in the material world, that is reflection of that spiritual sound. So when you hear sound, you can remember God. When you drink water, you can remember God. When you see some illumination, you can remember God. And when you chant some mantra, some hymn, that also you can remember God. So where you cannot remember God? Everywhere. This is Krishna consciousness, God consciousness. Always, 24 hours, we can remember Krishna. That remembrance means that Krishna is with me. Krishna is already with me. But as soon as we remember, that is factual. Because devotional service, Sevanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Mandanam, Dasam, there are 9 different processes of associating with God. The first preliminary association is Sevanam. Just like you are hearing, you are kindly hearing the speeches of Lord Krishna, that means you are associating with Krishna or God. Always remember, when you speak of Krishna, Krishna means God. So, because we are hearing, we are associating with God. And as we are associating with God, then our material contamination is being reduced. Sinnatam sagata krishna punna sravana kirtana. As we go on hearing, then the contamination which we have acquired in this material world, that is being reduced. So by the association of God in this way, by consciousness, that here is God, here is Krishna. In sound, there is Krishna. In the taste of the water, there is Krishna. In the illumination, there is Krishna. So how you can avoid Krishna? Every step you can remember Krishna. And if you can remember in that way, then your association is permanent. 24 hours your association is Krishna. The association with Krishna means that light, association with daylight, sunshine. There is no question of contamination. If you get sunshine always, or you will never be ultraviolet rays, that is scientific truth. If you are always in the sunshine, there will be no disease. This is a practical thing. This is a practical fact that modern medical science, they approve a disease, incurable. They recommend just lie down on the sunshine. Yes, it is a fact. And the Vedic rules, one man who is diseased, he worships sun. That means he has to come into the sunshine. And naturally, his disease will be cured. Similarly, as you associate with sunshine, you are cured of all diseases. Similarly, if you associate with Krishna, always, by consciousness, there is no trouble. There is no material trouble. Try it. Simply by sounding, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Not only sounding, this is also going on. At the same time, this consciousness, this water is Krishna, the taste of the water is Krishna, the sound is Krishna, this illumination is Krishna. In this way you have to practice. The only thing is that our present stage is forgetfulness. We have forgotten, that's all. So, we have to revive. We have to revive our spiritual life, our spiritual consciousness. And the simple process is this savanam. This act which you are performing, this is approved by Lord Satan. Sane sita suti gatam tanumam manovi. When Lord Chaitanya was speaking with Ramananda Rai, he is a great friend of Lord Chaitanya and great devotee, just like Krishna and Arjuna. So, Ramananda Rai was explaining about gradual development of spiritual life. So, he recommended so many things, varnasam dharma, sannyas, and renunciation of a work. Lord Chaitanya says, no, it is not so good, it is not so good, it is not so good. In this way, when he was Lord Ramananda Rai, he was proposing something that this is the system of promoting spiritual consciousness, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was rejecting, no, no, he said something more, better. Then he was proposing another, and the eighth stage, when Ramananda Rai cited one verse from the Vedic literature, this literature is Jnane Priyasam Udupasana Mantaiva Sanamakharitam Abhavadiya Vartam Thane Sthita Sutigatam Tanumanga Manovi Deprayasa Adita Jitapvasi Taitilakyam. The purpose of this verse is that Jnane Priyasam Udupasya, one should give up his unnecessary endeavor for philosophical speculation about God. One should give it up. Jnana prayasam, because by speculation you cannot reach to the ultimate truth. How far? How can just suppose we are speculating, very great scientists are speculating about the nature of the moon from here. But they are speculating, they have not come to any conclusion. So you go on speculating, which you have no experience. You go on speculating, but the real nature of that thing will never come to you. So Jnana Priyasam, especially for understanding God, a God consciousness, a speculation is useless. So Lord Chaitanya, the Bhagavad says, the Jnana Priyasam Udupasya, that sort of endeavor, speculating, should be given up. Namanteva, it just becomes submissive. It just becomes submissive, that what I am, an insignificant creature in this universe. This world, this earth is an insignificant point in the universe. And within this earth, the America, it is a small spot. And within America, this New York City is another small spot. And in this New York City, I am there. So what is my importance? So we should understand that we are very insignificant in comparison to the creation of the whole cosmic situation and all. So we should be very submissive. We should understand our position. Artificially, we should not be fucked up, the frog philosophy. The frog philosophy is that a frog in the well, he was informed about the Atlantic Ocean by his friend. And the frog inquired from his, what is that Atlantic Ocean? It is a huge, vast span of water. Now the frog is in the well, he is thinking, it may be double than this well, or it may be triple than this well, or 100 times, in this way calculating. But do you think, by such calculation, the frog will ever come to the conclusion of how length and breadth is of an Atlantic Ocean? So this is all frog philosophy. we are very teeny. Our knowledge, power of speculating is limited, always. So we cannot speculate about the Supreme. This is a useless waste of time. Therefore, Bhagavad says, you give up this. You give up this process of speculating. Jnane prayasam udapasya, give it up. Then, what is next? Now be samisi. Be samis. Then, all right, let me become samisi. Then, next. Jnane prayasam udapasya namantaiva sanamukaritana bhavadiya vata. You just try to understand. Just try to hear the message of God. The message of God is just like Bhagavad Gita or Bible, any, as you like. Just try to hear. Sanmukhritang Bhattam, from realized soul. Just like the truth of Bible was spoken by Lord Jesus Christ or Krishna, any, whatever you like, you hear. Jnani prasam udapasanamanta eva sanmukhritam bhavadiya vartam. But you must hear about the Supreme Personality of Godhead and nothing more. That should be your purpose. Then, what will be the result? The result will be sthane sthita, in whatever condition you are, that doesn't matter. Oh, I am very poor man, that doesn't matter. Oh, I am very rich man, doesn't matter. Oh, I am European, doesn't matter. I am Indian, doesn't matter. I am born very low, or doesn't matter. Anything, unconditional. In women, whatever you are, that doesn't matter. If you simply hear, sthane sthita siti gata amatum, if you simply give your oral reception to this transcendental word, the result will be that God, who can never be conquered, will conquer God. How he'll conquer? He'll conquer by love. God cannot be conquered, but he can be conquered by love. Just like Arjuna. Arjuna was a friend of Krishna. How he conquered? The Krishna became his driver. The personality of Godhead, who is the supreme, everyone's master, he became a menial servant of Arjuna. So God is so lovable, and he reciprocates his love in this way. So you can conquer. That's why Krishna became the son of Nanda Maharaj. And when he was child, he took the shoes of Nanda Maharaj on his head. Just like child play, you see. So these are symptoms of conquering God. What? You are trying to become one with God, or you can become father of God. You can become father of God. God has no father, but he accepts his devotee, his lover, or you are my father. So that is the question. So, if this process is false, simply hearing oral reception sincerely, then by this process, whatever position I may be, I can conquer the Supreme Lord. He agrees to be conquered. This Krishna consciousness should be spread. It is very easy. You didn't quote us. You remember Krishna. You hear something. Suppose there are so many sounds that are occurring in the street. But if you know that this sound is Krishna, then in every step you will feel Krishna. Then again he says, punna danda pritik dhyansha tejasyasmi vibhavaso jivanam sarva bhuteshu tapasyasmi tapasyasi. He's describing more elaborately. How is that? The punnagandha priti dhyancha. Punnagandha means flavor. The flavor. Any flavor, that is Krishna, that is God. You cannot create any flavor. Synthetically, we may create some sense, but that is not as good as natural sense. So that is, when you have a good flavor, you can remember, here is God, here is Krishna. When there is some natural beauty, Oh, you can understand. Here is Krishna. And when there is something uncommon, very powerful, wonderful, you can understand. Here is Krishna. And when there is life, Jivana, as long as tree lives, as long as man lives, as long as animal lives. So, you understand, this life is part and parcel of Krishna. As soon as the part and parcel of Krishna, the spark is taken away from that body, everything gone. No meaning. So nice brain we are acting. Sir Isaac Newton, Sir Jagadish Chandra Bose. But as soon as that small particle of Krishna's part and parcel is removed from this body, no more Sir Isaac Newton working. Yes. Jivanam Sarvabhutanam. He is alive. He is alive. You can see his every step, God. People say, can you show me God? Yes, God is seen in so many ways. You just try to see. If you close your eyes that I shall not see God, then who can show you? But you can see God in every step. Jivanam Sarvabhuteshu. Tapaskasmi, tapasishu, tapaskasmi, any kind of penance, any kind of perseverance, that is also God. Tapaskasmi, tapasishu, bijam mam sarvabhutanam, vidhi partha sanatanam. A bijam. Bijam means seed. The seed is sanatan, that is itan. Sanatan means itan. There is a gigantic tree, but what is the platform? What is the background of this gigantic tree? Seed, that is small seed. That mustard-like grain seed, that is the background of this large tree. Bijangamam sarvabhutanam vidhi partha sanatanam. And that seed is eternal. The seed within me, within you, everyone, the seed is there. And as soon as the seed takes place in the mother's womb, the seed becomes so fructified little by little. And then it comes out. When it is properly developed with hands and legs and eyes, it comes out from the mother's womb. Then again develops. Again the birth, he becomes a boy, he becomes a youth, he becomes so many things, changes everything. But that seed is permanent. The body is changing, but the seed is there. That's why it is sanatana. It is very easy to understand how we change our body. We are changing our body every moment. Imperceptibly. Imperceptibly we are changing our body. Every moment, every second, the change of body is a fact. Therefore, that bijam, that small particle spark of spirit, that is sanatana. This body is changing. Now, when it is changed to another body, that means transmigration of the soul from one body to another. So this is a fact, and it is not very difficult to understand. We are changing our body every moment. Bijam mam sarvabhutanam vidhi partha sanatanam. Buddhi buddhimatam asmi. One who is very intelligent. That intelligence, extraordinary intelligence, must be considered. He's Krishna. Without being especially favored by Krishna, nobody can become extraordinarily intelligent. Everyone is trying that I shall be more intelligent than my friend, my others. But without Krishna's, special favor, nobody can become extraordinarily intelligent. Therefore, wherever you find extraordinarily intelligent, you should consider, there is Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. Buddhi buddhimatam asmi tejas tejasinam maham. One who is very influential. That influence is Krishna. That influence, that particular influence of a particular man, that is also Krishna. Balam balavatam chaham. One is very strong, stout and strong. That particular strength is also Krishna. Just like an elephant. He's very strong. And more than elephant, the gorilla is still more strong. That strength, where from? Where from it gets strength? Now suppose I am a human being. I cannot get such strength by my own endeavor. But I can get strength 10,000 times more than the elephant if Krishna favors. That was strength. Just like Bhima. Bhima has strength 10,000 times than an elephant. You are so strong. There is no question of not believing. Because as I find, you are stronger than me and he is stronger than you. Similarly, there are many degrees of strength. Now these degrees of strength is Krishna. So you can understand Krishna. Without Krishna's favor, nobody can be stronger than the other. So, balam balabhatam, that's me. Kamaraga vivarjita. Kama. Kama means desire. Raga vivarjita, without attraction. Desire with attraction, that is Krishna. Desire with attraction, how can be possible? Desire with attraction. Whenever we desire something, I want some young girl. I desire. Desire means I have got attraction. But desire without attraction, how it is possible? Can you explain? Yes. Desire without attraction means Krishna consciousness. I desire for Krishna's benefit, not for my benefit. That is desire without attraction. So there is kamaraga vivarjita. Kamaraga vivarjitam dharma viruddha bhuteshu kamosmi bharata sabha. And lust it is not against religious principle. That is also I am. What is that lust? Lust means generally means sex life. Sex life which is not against religious principle. That is Krishna. And how it is religious principle, sex life? Yes. Sex life is religious principle in this way that when you want a good child, in that sense if you undertake sex life, that is sanctioned, that is religious. And without that everything, sex life is non-religious. If you can produce a good child, you can have 1,000 times sexual intercourse. But if you produce cats and dogs, don't take. That is irreligious. So here it is stated, the dharma viruddha bhuteshu. Therefore, for sex life, dharma is marriage. In the human society, there is marriage. In the animal society, there is no marriage. They indulge in sex life anyway, because they are animals. But in human society, either Hindu society or Muslim society or Christian society or any society, any civilized society, there is the marriage. So the marriage, sex life by marriage is religious. And sex life without marriage, that is irreligious. So, here Krishna says, the sex life of a dharmaviruddha, which is not against religious principle, that is I am. So there is no harm to become a householder. It is not that I am a sannyasi, I have given a household life. And one person who is a householder, there is no difference, provided it is on the principle of religion. I am a sannyasi, I am forbidden to make any association with women. I cannot talk even with a woman in a lonely place. That is forbidden. I cannot talk with a woman. I will give you one practical example. When my Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master, was living, and speaking about 50 years before, we are all young men at that time. And one of my god brother, he was also a young man, Dr. Audhyari Kapoor, and his wife was also young. So his wife wanted to speak with my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj was at that time not less than 60 or more than that. And the girl, my friend's wife, he was not more than 22 years. But actually, she was just like his granddaughter. But she proposed, Sir, I wanted to speak with you something confidentially. My Guru Maharaj says, oh, no, I cannot speak with you confidentially. You can speak whatever you like, see here. Just speak. I cannot speak. There is so much age difference, so much, affections, still he refused. No, I cannot talk with you confidentially because you are woman. So, a sannyasi is forbidden not to talk even in private place with woman. But a householder, if he associates woman under marriage time, then it is religious. And without this is irreligious. And that religious sex life is God. Religious sex life is God. This is the follow. If we, every one of us reading Bhagavad Gita, every one of us, at least so far India is concerned, that is a different thing. In America also, I find so many young American gentlemen, they read Bhagavad Gita. But I am afraid if they are reading Bhagavad Gita and so scrutinizing it, as it is stated here. Dharma aviriddha bhuteshu kamasmi bharatartha. Sex life, which is not against religious principle, that is I. Regulated sex life, marriage life, that is Krishna. So that is not without Krishna. That is Krishna. Then he says, Jechaiva sattika bhava rajasa tamasa sajye matra eviti tanavitte natu ham tesu mai. Now one may question, then if you are particularly, your personality of God is Supreme God, you are speaking that you are sound, you are this light, you are this pranava, you are this bija, you are also kama, so many things. So, do you mean to say that you are simply in goodness? And what about the other things? Because there are three qualities of the material world. The modes of goodness and the modes of passion and the modes of darkness. Now, so far Krishna describes himself that any good thing, just like sex life, with marriage is a good, that's all you are. What about other things? Then Krishna replied, he automatically says that the jeshaiva sattika bhava rajasas tamasas jhe. Whatever there are in this material world, you will find interaction of three qualities only. Goodness, passion and ignorance. All manifestations that you have observed, they are different combination of these three qualities. Now that can be made into 9. 3 into 3 equal to 9. 9 into 9 equal to 81 and so on. Go on diluting. But the main background is that three qualities. The Lord says that whatever qualities are there, jeshaiva sattika bhava Rajasas, Tamasas to give, either goodness or passion or ignorance. Matta eviti tanvidhi. They are all produced from me. They are all produced from me. How is that? Natu aham tesu te mai. That they are, because they are produced from me, therefore they are standing. Their position is in me, but I am not there. I am transcendent. So, in another sense, even the bad thing, evil thing, which is produced out of ignorance, that is also Krishna. But when? When it is applied by Krishna. How it is that? Practical example. Now, an electrical engineer, he is producing electricity energy. Now, you are feeling at your home, in the refrigerator it is cold, and in the heater it is hot. But in the original generating station, it is electricity. It is neither cold, neither hot. So these qualitative manifestations of the world, they are different for me. For Krishna there is no difference. Therefore, sometimes if Krishna acts on the principle of this ignorance, that for Krishna it is Krishna. Just like the for the electric engineer, the whole energy is electricity, nothing. He has no distinction, this is cold and this is hot. This is the philosophy. Matta eveti tana vidhi, natu, nattaham tesu te mai. Everything is being generated. And the Vedanta Sutra confirms it. Janma dasya jataha. Everything. That is the supreme truth. From where everything is emanating. That is supreme truth. So, what we are thinking bad, good, oh, that is bad and good for me because I am conditioned. But because he is not conditioned, that was for him, there is no bad and good. He is not conditioned. I am conditioned, that's why I am feeling heat and cold. But because he is not conditioned, everything is all right for him. So, such is Krishna. The how Krishna has described himself as he is. But why we are not attracted to Krishna? That is explained in the next. Krihi gunamayai bhavai revhi sarvamidam jagat mohitam nabhijanati mame bhav paramabhyam. Because their illusion by the intermixture of these three qualities, mohita, their illusion. Sri gunamai bhavi revi sarvam idam jagat. Idam jagat, this material world is spread all over with these three gunas or three qualities of material nature. Now, from here you can understand that the division of social order, as it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita, Chatur Bandam Maya Srishtam Guna Karma Vibhagasaha, that the four division of human society is made by me. How it is that Guna Karma Vibhagasaha, according to the material qualities and work. So, in the Vedic literature in India, you find there are four divisions of human society. The Brahmin, the Kshatriya, the Vaishya and the Sudra. But that is natural. That is not artificial. People misunderstand that Indians have created a caste system. No, that caste system is everywhere. Sarvam idam jagat. Not only India, all universe is being conducted by that process. Even here also you have got that caste system. Some of you, are in the modes of goodness, some of you are in the modes of passion, some of you are in the modes of ignorance, and some of you are in the mixed quality. So that is prevailing all over the world. And those who are in the modes of goodness, they are Brahmin. Oh, name may be another thing. Oh, you may say, this man is very intelligent, very moralist. Oh, that means he is a Brahmin. And this man is very good administrator. Oh, that means he is Kshatriya. Oh, this man is very good industrialist, merchant. Oh, that means he is Vaishya. Oh, this man is cannot do anything. Oh, he is Sudra. So, Lord Krishna says, then the Trivi Gunamayi Bhav, by these three qualities, everywhere, all over the universe, you must know, whenever Krishna says something, it is nothing, limited. Universally true, he says. When he says this, Sarvajoni Sukantya, he claims to be father of all living entities. In the animals, in the aquatics, in the trees, plants, worms, birds, beasts, this human being, that human being, all he claims. Is the father of everyone. Similarly, Trivi Gunamayi Bhavi Mohikam Sarvina. The whole world is, I am to say, innocent, covered by these reactions of these three qualities. And we are under the spell of that illusion. Therefore, we cannot understand what is God. What is God? Trivigunamayi bhavai revi sarvavidam jagat mohitam nabhijanati. Because they are now illusions under the spell of the intermixture of these three qualities, they cannot understand me, Krishna. Mame bhav param abhyam, I am the supreme eternal being. They cannot understand. So, this illusion, so what is the nature of this illusion? How it can be overcome? That is also explained here. Devi jisa gunamai mamamaya durattaya mami vajit prapadanti mayami tantarantiti. You cannot do it by mental speculation. You cannot get rid of this entanglement of three qualities. It is not possible. It is very strong. Don't you think how we are in the grip of the material nature? That is not possible. David Jisa Gunamayi Mamamaya. Guna. Guna means this quality. And another meaning of guna is rope. Just like you have seen rope, one rope, two rope, three rope. When three ropes are bound up, twisted in one, that becomes very strong. The guna means rope also. So we are tied up hands and feet with that rope of this quality, three. You see? It is very difficult to get out of it. Then, hopelessness, now, of no hopelessness. How can I get rid of it? Mami vada prapadanti mayami tang tarantite. Anyone who surrenders unto me, he gets lost to. Anyone who becomes Krishna conscious, by this way or that way, he becomes free. Thank you very much.